Hello, you guys. Welcome or welcome back to the Marketing Empress. I have to thank you guys for the 220 subscribers that you helped me achieve. And thanks to that, I'm releasing the next video in this GDBI process series. Now, this video is going to be slightly different. And one of the subscribers got in touch with me and told me that I should basically create a video that talks about the 10 things that you need to take into consideration to crack a virtual GDBI. For your college placements or getting into a college after an MBA exam is done. Now guys, there are multiple things that you need to consider, but there are these 10 things that I have always ensured, which has helped me crack multiple interviews, and I hope it's going to help you guys as well. So if you're interested, keep on watching. Number 1, location and lighting. Location and lighting are going to be extremely important when you're trying to present yourself. There are a couple of things that you need to consider while being a part of a virtual GDBI. First, the person needs to be able to see you, all right? So one of the crucial mistakes that you need to avoid are sitting against a window. At the back, if you have a window, your face is not visible in the camera. So always ensure that you're sitting facing the light. So the light should come from the front and it should be such that your face is clearly visible in the camera. What I also mean by location is that your backdrop should ideally be a plain wall or else a wall with minimal patterns. You also have some virtual backgrounds available on apps like Zoom, Microsoft Teams, etc. You can definitely make use of that, but understand that your virtual backgrounds may make yourself, your face a little blurry, and it depends on your internet connectivity issues as well.
Number 2, attire.
Second important part is your attire. Now guys, remember that you're not meeting the interviewer face to face. So there's hardly anything that is going to be visible with respect to your overall appearance. Even when you're doing a virtual GDPI, I think this is all that is visible in the camera. Now, if that is the case, irrespective, you need to wear a shirt, look formal in your appearance, all right? You may be asked to wear a blazer, but that depends on your colleges. But if you're not asked specifically for any attire, a formal shirt is what you need to be wearing. For a girl, it may also be important that you tie your hair up instead of leaving your hair open. Now, why do I say this is because when you're trying to talk, if your hair is sort of covering your face, then it may not come across as something, quite appealing to the interviewer.
Number 3, your posture or body language.
Guys, understand that your body language can also be depicted through your face alone. So, as a practice, throughout the entire GDPI session, have a smile on your face. Now, I'm not asking you to be, very broad smile or something like that. But you need to be confident through your smile. You need to be attentive. You cannot be looking here and there and try to answer things. The interviewer may be focusing only on one candidate at one point of time. And if that's you, you need to be attentive throughout. You need to be sitting straight. You need to be engrossed in what the person is talking about. But at the same time, ensure that you do not have any facial expressions that show that you're bored or you're not understanding what's really happening. Even if that's the case, guys.
Number 4. Should you start first?
The next thing that I wanted to cover in this particular video and is something that a lot of people ask me. Should I start first in a group discussion? Well, the answer to that is it depends. Now, this particular assumption or this particular misconception that a lot of people have is that if you start first in a GD, you get brownie points. That may not always be the case. In fact, if you start first in a GD where you don't have absolutely any idea about what the topic is, it can act as a negative. All right. So ensure that you are the first one to talk only if you know the topic in depth. And the first part, what you start off with, should never be just the topic repeat. All right, so you're just repeating what the topic is and you're setting forth the stage for others to talk. When you're trying to start first, Start by introducing the topic, that's fine. Besides that, also add in your point of view. Then leave it to the next person to talk.
Number 5. How to talk.
Next, let's understand how do we talk. You need to talk in a way that shows that you're loud enough. Okay? You don't want the interviewer to tell you that, you know, you should be talking a little louder or be a little loud, I can't hear you. These are the points you need to definitely avoid. You need to be loud. You need to be clear. You need to be confident. Okay? These three things are extremely important. Confidence, guys, reflects in the way you're answering or you're putting forth your points. When you're saying something which is possibly against what your other teammates also talk about, you still need to be confident about it. Because when you're confident, it reflects in a good way that you are trying to put forth a point you completely believe in and something that you stand by. You need to be loud, you need to be clear in what you're trying to communicate.
Number 6. Making notes.
Making notes. Extremely important. There can be a case discussion or a group discussion wherein they ask you to summarize the entire discussion. What happens then? If you do not have notes or points written down, it may be very difficult for you to memorize everything that the discussion entails and then talk about it. So, it's always going to be extremely important to have a small notepad with you and make points for and against when it comes to for and against topic provided to you or with a case discussion, different approaches suggested by people. Always make a note of that because you never know if you are asked to summarize a particular case or a group discussion, you should have all the relevant points noted so that you can talk about it.
Number 7. Interrupting someone else.
Next, another important part. How do you go about interrupting someone? Now, one of the things that I've noticed and a lot of students have even told me that when it comes to a virtual GD, it becomes a fish market. Everyone is trying to be loud. Everyone is trying to break someone else's point and try to pitch in because the time is limited and you need to prove your point. But it's going to act against you if you just keep interrupting someone else or making someone stop midway. Instead, one of the easier ways to go about doing this is there can be someone in the group who is continuously talking and not letting someone else talk. That person is definitely going to be at a disadvantage because he's not receptive to the comments that his group members might have. However, if you are in a GD wherein there is a person who's continuously talking and not letting you talk, there are certain ways in which you can interrupt. What you can say is that I agree to what you're saying, but this is another way where we can look at things. Or, while your point is valid, what I think is, and continue with your point. But there may always be a chance that that person is not letting you talk at all. In a situation like that, make your pitch a little higher. Talk a little loudly so that the person pauses and you get a chance to talk or make a point. This has worked really well in my favor and I'm sure can help you as well.
Number 8. How can you ensure that a conclusion is reached?
Now, one of the important things is that your virtual GD will be restricted with respect to time. There'll be time constraints that come into the picture. But as a part of this particular group that you are interacting in, it's important that you have a conclusion at the end. All right. And most of the time, students face this problem that someone or the other just keeps talking to and fro or something like that, for and against something like that. And you lose out on time to understand or have a conclusion. At that point of time, what I suggest you to do is keep an idea about the time that you've spent in discussing a particular topic. And if no one else is taking the lead, you take the lead and try to derive a conclusion based on the majority that are for or majority that are against a particular topic. Trust me, guys, this is going to give you a lot of brownie points. Because at the end of the day, a conclusion is what matters.
Number 9. Should you conclude?
The next part is, should I conclude a particular GD? Now, well, that depends. If you've been making notes throughout the session, if you know what your conclusion is driving towards, of course it makes a lot of sense to conclude. But more often than not, there might be a case where the interviewer randomly picks someone to do the conclusion. If that's not happening, then of course go ahead and take that lead. But if they are letting someone else conclude, do not, and I repeat, do not go ahead and again try to conclude something after that person has spoken. Okay? Don't try to show that you are looking out for every opportunity where you can have the spotlight on yourself. That's not the aim of the entire process.
Lastly, number 10. What to do if you don't know the topic?
This is something I had to cover because I faced this in my own experience while being a part of multiple GDs. What do you do when you're absolutely clueless about a particular topic that's asked in your GD? Do you give up at the start itself? Hell no. Okay. I have had this situation and this is exactly how you go about approaching it. Stop. Do not be the first one to talk. All right. Understand what the others are talking about and build your points based on that. For example, a person A starts the particular topic and gives you a basic idea about what the topic is. Well, you have the base ready to talk on. The second person might have a different opinion. All right. Now, between the two opinions that are already stated, you pick one side and start talking on it. All right. You might be building up on what someone else has already spoken about, but that's okay. You need to ensure that you're not talking about something completely different from what is being discussed. Because you may not be sure if it's related to the topic. Because, well, you're absolutely clueless what the topic is about. So that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed and learned something out of it. I can assure you that if you take into account all of these 10 points, I am guaranteeing you that your interview or your GD process will be a smooth ride. So ensure that you practice on these 10 things and you keep yourself prepared for whatever GD process that you have in the future. For the next video in this series, I will need a total of 230 subscribers. So please ensure that you like, share and subscribe to the channel by hitting the bell notification icon and help me achieve the 230 subscriber mark. Until next time, bye-bye.